radio detection and ranging, an electronic system which can detect and measure the range and bearing of objects. The switch on procedure. Check if radar scanner and mast is clear. Put all controls to minimum. Make sure gyro inputs and speed inputs correct to the radar. Put radar on standby for warm-up up to 3 minutes. After warm-up is complete, press transmit on. The adjusting controls of a radar. The first one is brilliance. This control is used for adjusting the brightness of the radar screen. This control is set till the trace is visible. The next control is the tune. This control is used to match the transmitting and receiving frequency. This control is set till we get the best possible picture on the screen. The tuning indicator bar below this shows how much the frequency is set to, and this bar should be at maximum. Next is the gain. This control amplifies the signal strength. This control shall be set till a dotted or speckled background is obtained. This shows the amplified strength of the received echoes. The next control is the anti-sea clutter. This control removes and suppresses echoes up to 3 nautical miles. This control shall be set optimum for the present condition. The next control is the anti-rain clutter. This control breaks up rain echoes over the entire range. As shown on the screen, this shall be set if the present target is visible. This control shall be reduced to minimum if there is no rain. The next control is adjusting the range. The range shall be changed frequently once in a while, and shall also be kept for long range once in a while. The rain scale varies from 0.25 to 96 miles. Next is the selection of the pulse length. There are three that you can choose from: short pulse, long pulse, and medium pulse. The types of radar. There are two types that you can choose from, X band and S band. The X band, the wavelength is of 3 cm and it is used for short range scanning. There is more clutter from sea spray and swell in this mode. The next is the S band mode. In this mode, the wavelength is of 10 cm. It is used for long range scanning and there is less clutter in this mode. Next comes the range rings. There are 6 concentric equidistant circles. Next is the range rings. 6 concentric equidistant circles from which distance can be measured. For example, a 6 nautical mile or 12 nautical miles. When it is 6 nautical miles, the distance between the rings is 1 nautical mile. And when changed to 12 nautical miles, the distance changes to 2. Next is the electronic bearing line. The EBL button as shown on the screen is for this purpose. We can take the bearing of a target and the box will show its bearing. Next is the variable range marker. By increasing or decreasing diameter of range circle, we can get the range of the target and the reading is shown in the box. Next is the picture orientation. There are 3 modes to choose from: the north up mode, the head up mode and the course up mode. First is the north up mode. In this mode, the true north will be shown on top of the display screen and the bearings given are all true bearings. Next is the head up mode. In this, the heading marker is on top and the target changes according to the heading in the radar. In this mode, we can take the relative bearings. The next is the course up mode. In this mode, our course remains on top. The ship's heading changes instead of target and the course moves the heading marker. The next mode is the course up mode. In this, our course remains on top. The ship's heading changes. Instead of target or course moving, the heading marker will move from the top, that is the course. Next is the relative motion. Our position fixed in radar, target moves across screen relative to own vessel. Next is the true motion. In this mode, our ship moves across the screen of the radar with own ship, course and speed. The own position will reset itself when own ship gets 1/4 of the screen towards the end. Targets move with own true motion.